is Dr. Krzysztof Leszek-Briniewski from Poland, and he's going to be talking about the risk of hypertension and inflammation in apparently healthy individuals from different polluted cities.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I have the honor to introduce you to our study swiftly to show you our study investigating the links between the place of residence, which is the cities which differ mainly in air pollution levels, and also the selected markers of cardiovascular disease. The links between air pollution and mortality and many diseases such as cardiovascular disease are well known. As we are in London, I think the best example for the mortality will be the Great Smoke in 1952, when the sudden increase in air pollutants levels caused more than 4,000 of deaths during the short period of time. And when we talk about the cardiovascular disease and air pollution, one of the theories linking two of them is inflammation. And there are many studies assessing the air pollution levels in, there are many studies assessing the inflammatory biomarkers in areas with different air pollution levels, but their results are inconsistent. Moreover, there are studies stating that higher air pollution may cause the higher blood pressure. And most of the studies were described for adults. Therefore, our aim was to investigate if there will be any difference in selected markers of cardiovascular disease, such as blood pressure and biochemical markers, in healthy teenagers living in two cities which primarily differ in air pollution levels. To conduct our study, we have chosen two polluted cities, Kraków and Lublin, basically saying Kraków have two times higher air pollutants than Lublin. And the map you can see represents on the red the concentrations, annual concentrations for PM2.5 and PM10. And as you can see, where Kraków is located in the red color, and it means that all of these air pollutants are exceeded. To conduct our study, we have recruited our patients in the secondary schools. We recruited altogether, we recruited 2,605 teenagers, of whom we randomly selected 900. And 826 of them had their blood measurements taken, and 600 had their blood tests carried out. Surprisingly, we found that when we analyzed the whole study population, we did not find any difference in systolic or diastolic blood pressure. But when we analyzed the males and females separately, we found that systolic blood pressure was higher in males living in Kraków. And as you can see, no differences were found when we looked at the females. Moreover, both high sensitive CRP levels and fibrinogen levels, which are the biomarkers of inflammation and cardiovascular risk disease, were higher in Kraków. And we also observed these differences when we analyzed both males and females separately. Afterwards, we also looked at the teenagers with and without overweight. And we observed that moderate increase in BMI was associated with higher blood pressure, but only systolic, and only in Kraków, not in Lublin. We also found differences in high sensitive CRP levels, and they were higher in both cities in the children with higher BMI, but the differences were more pronounced in Kraków. In summary, we observed that the systolic blood pressure in males was higher in Kraków, but on the other hand, we did not find any differences in the whole analyzed study population and in females. Moreover, we found increased inflammatory biomarkers in Kraków, and we also found the association between increase in BMI and blood pressure or selected inflammatory biomarkers when observing the teenagers in Kraków. So thank you very much.
Time for questions. Again, in this study, there was a question before about gender differences, and there seem to be some gender difference here. I think the message is not that women are protected against pollution, and that there are, beyond cardiovascular disease, there are other consequences of pollution that we should always keep in mind. Questions? What do you think could be the implications of your findings for the city of Krakow, for example? What should they do now?
Well, when we basically compare these two cities, the implication is that the teenagers living in Krakow has this higher inflammatory biomarkers and also have males higher systolic blood pressure. So maybe, but only maybe, in the future they may be more prone to other cardiovascular disease or hypertension. But as there are many factors to take into account when comparing air pollution, we also should make bigger studies to see if this really true.
If I understand you right, you use CRP as a kind of signal system for vascular walls being starting to protest. Now, why did you take teenagers? Why didn't you take kids or students, whatever? What's the reason to take that group?
Because there are almost none studies regarding the air pollution and in this group. I mean, you can always see the studies in adults, but then there are many, many factors which also influence, for example, high sensitivity CRP levels or even the blood pressure. And we theorize that in the adults, these differences would be smaller, so we could basically see the healthy, because we also made the short questionnaire regarding their health status, and we knew that they were basically healthy, so in general, they should not have any diseases.
I might have missed this, but you corrected this for smoking, as boys are smoking more.
Yes, we also look at that, and you also should remember that this was generally people with an age 16, 17, 18, which basically rather do not smoke, and even if they smoke, it's just for a short period of time, so it's not like smoking for last 10 years.
How is smoking in teenage?
We corrected for that, and the results were the same.
Okay.
Any more questions? If not,